Hello friends, welcome to our channel. So in this session, let us have a look on a simple C program to print the Fibonacci series. First of all, what is meant by this Fibonacci series? How this Fibonacci series will be performed? So the first element, always the first element will be 0. And the next element will be 1. And after taking this 0 and 1, the third element will be addition of first two numbers. That means 0 plus 1 is 1. Again, this element will comes this one and this one plus. So previous two elements, addition of previous two elements will give the present element. That means 1 plus 1, again 2. Again, 1 plus 2, it gives 3. Again, 2 plus 3 gives 5. Again, 5 and 3 addition gives 8. 8 and 5 addition gives 13, and so on. This is the Fibonacci series. So always the first two numbers will be 0 and 1. And for getting the current number, we have to add the previous two numbers. So for adding previous two numbers 0 and 1, we will get the 1. And for getting the next element, we have to add the previous two elements. That means 1 plus 1, 2. And for getting the next number, we have to add the previous two elements. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 5, 8. So on. So we have to write a C program to display this Fibonacci series. So for this, we have to take an input as how many elements this Fibonacci series must be printed. So let us take that. So main function, let us take one loop variable, because we have to solve this problem statement by using iterative statement. So we have to use the iterative statement. For the iterative statements, we have to use a loop variable. So let us declare I as a loop variable. And then, so we have to take input the number of elements to be printed. So let us take n as an input. And we have to initialize the first element and the second element. So let us take A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. So I have taken the first two elements. Now current element will be A plus B. The third element will be second element plus first element. Fourth element will be third element plus second element. Fifth element will be fourth element plus third element. Now so first enter the n value, that means how many numbers we have to print. So for reading the value, we have to use a scanf function. As it is an integer data type, we have to use a %d and ampersand n. So this statement, we will get the value of n. And now I have to repeat the statements, that means we have to add the previous two elements. So first of all, we have to print this first two elements. Printf %d slash t %d. Here slash t is a space, horizontal space, A comma B. Now I have to print the third element. For that third element, I have to use I is equal to 0, I less than, or first two elements, we have taken the first two elements, so I have to start from the third element.
I have to start from the third element. I less than or equal to n I plus plus. I have to calculate C is equal to A plus B, and A value should be B, B value should be A. Sorry, C. And then we have to print the C value. Slash T. Close. So this is a simple program to implement the Fibonacci series. Let us trace this one so that you can clearly understand. First of all, I have declared two variables, A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. And next, read the value, let it be n is equal to 5. I have taken an input, 5, that is assigned to n. So, I need 5 elements to be printed in the Fibonacci series. The first 5 elements to be printed. So, next, printf A comma B. So, here A comma B is printed, 0 and 1 will be printed. Here. So 0, 1 will be printed. Next, for I is equal to 3, I is equal to 3, 3 less than or equal to 5, 3 less than or equal to 5. So condition is true. So C is equal to A plus B. C is equal to, so here A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1. So C is equal to A plus B. That means 1. And now A will be, B will be stored in A. So B value 1. So A is equal to 1. And C value will be stored in B. B is equal to 1. So C value 1. So B is equal to 1. Printf C. C value is 1. Again 1 will be printed here. Next, I is equal to 4. Incremented. So I plus plus. I will be 4 now. So 4 less than or equal to 5. Again the condition is true. Now again C is equal to A plus B. That means here A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1. 1 plus 1. That is 2. C is equal to 2. Now the B value will be saved into, assigned to A. So B value, now B value what is 1. So 1 is assigned to A and C value is assigned to B. C value, what is the C value? 2 is assigned to B. Again, I is incremented, I is equal to 5. Now, 5 less than or equal to 5. So again, the condition is true. Again, calculate the C value, C is equal to A plus B. That means 1 plus 2, now 1 plus 2, that is 3. So, A is will be, so B value is assigned to A. Here B value 2. So 2 is assigned to A. And C value is assigned to B. So, 3 will be assigned to B. Printf C. C is 3. So here C is 2. 2 is printed here. And now in the I is equal to 5. A is equal to, C is equal to A plus B. So 3 will be printed here. And next I is equal to 6. So 6 less than or equal to 5. Condition fails. Comes out from the loop. So the output will be 0, 1, 1, 2, 3. And if it is n is equal to 6, again A plus B, C is equal to A plus B, now 2 plus 3, C is equal to 5. So 5 will be printed here. So coming to this sequence, see 0 plus 1 will be 1, 1 plus 2 will be 3. So the output will be 0, 1, 2 and 3. So this is a simple program, simple logic program to print the Fibonacci series up to n elements. Hope you understood this program. So if you are having any doubts regarding this C program, feel free to write a comment of your doubt so that I will definitely try to clarify your doubts. And if you like my sessions, please share my sessions with your friends and do subscribe to my channel for more videos
on the C program. And thanks for listening. Thank you.